This isn't your first time at Over the Hill Festival, is it?
No, we played last year.
Was that the first time?
Yes. This is like the second time we've done an Over the Hill festival kind of thing, you know. Like we did the main Over the Hill last year.
Yep.
And then this year it's like I don't know if it's post or pre.
I think it's pre-party or something.
Is it pre Over the Hill 2014? So yeah, we played the actual Over the Hill 2013, and then we're playing this one. So.
Why did you come to Cornwall? Because you're one of the very few bands that does.
Because we've just got a fan base. We've developed a fan base down here. I think, you guys correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it's because of our association with, because we've got on the Quicksilver and stuff like that, and the surfing vibe down here and stuff, you know. I think it's just our association with Quicksilver and stuff got us fan base with a load of surfers and people based down in Cornwall. But
on,
I mean, we love coming down here anyway, so. Yeah. Like, I used to come down here when I was a kid for holidays and stuff, but. Like, yeah, we love coming down here anyway, so, you know.
You joined Iron Giant in 2008.
Yeah. Iron Giant formed in
2008.
Yeah.
So, what were you doing before that? I think I read somewhere you're in a band called Volume.
I was in a band called Volume, yeah.
Doing my research.
You've done your research,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was in a band called Volume. Like, I used to, we were like an indie kind of prog band kind of thing. Well, we just had some weird time signatures going on and shit. Before that, I used to do some. I used to run a nightclub,
really,
in Southampton. And then whilst I was doing that as well, I did some like guest vocals for. I did some kind of writing, vocal line writing, kind of. I was loosely involved with like Craig David and all that lot.
Really?
Before that.
I love Craig David.
It's really a really bad thing for a rock guy to admit, isn't it?
Oh, but no, I fucking
love. Some people come up to me. It's been quite funny. Like we've been on tour and shit. In New
you
Zealand.
And Craig?
No, not with me and Craig.
I love Craig David.
No, we've just been on tour and some random people that have obviously done their research come up to me and just go, "You used to sing with Craig David, didn't you?" I'm like, "Oh, fuck."
Do you still know him?
No, fuck no.
He lives in Miami now, eh?
Yeah. He's like pimping it big time. although Avid Merrin did completely ruin his career, didn't he?
Didn't he? Oh, that's
poor guy.
No, right? So,
anyway.
Yeah, exactly, fuck that. So, being in Iron Giant now,
yeah,
is this your only band?
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah, at the moment it's my only band, yeah, for sure. I've been looking at doing some kind of solo project, side project for a while. It's just getting the right guys to work with and stuff, getting the right people to write with and shit like that.
Kind
of. But Iron Giant is all of our main things, man, totally, 100%.
What's happening with your guitarist? Because you always seem to have a revolving door.
We've got a lucid guitarist. That's what I'd call it. Well, the guy when we first started, it was just because Paul is like an amazing, talented multi-instrumentalist. Yeah. Kind of like plays pretty much everything. He just wrote all the guitar parts. Him and Shelton wrote all the music for like a lot of the first album. So he just wrote all the guitar parts anyway. So when we came to like us playing live, we were like,
we need
our
a guitarist.
Bass. We need another guy to play guitar. So we got a guy, Max, in, who just didn't work out. He was a bit young or whatever. He was a lovely guy, like really nice guy, but he was going his own separate ways. He wanted to do his own kind of thing, like more jazz kind of stuff rather than rock. And then we got Asia in, he was a Kiwi guy. And we kind of, by nature of, well, you know what the rock industry's like at the moment. It's no one's earning any money out of it and stuff like that. So, but to ask a Kiwi guy to move over to the UK for us is a big ask. And we've asked two guys now to come over to the UK from New Zealand, which is Asia and our friend Fish as well. And they just can't, it's just too much. It's a big move, and you know, it's a big move to ask people to do that. So we've just got like a session guitarist kind of situation with our guitarist. Like when we play in the UK, we get the Hannes, our German guy, or our mate Trips to do it.
Oh, the German Canadian guy.
Yeah, German Canadian
guy.
Yeah, he's a good dude, eh?
Yeah.
Or we get our mate Trips to do it. When we play in New Zealand, we get our mate Fish to do it. So it kind of works for us because we don't have to fly the same person all around the world with us, you know? It kind of works in our favour, kind of thing.
So, new album, when is it out? And what do you love it?
Well, I love it, yeah. It sounds awesome. Like the last one's like here, the new one's like way up here kind of thing. It sounds amazing. We sent it off for mastering yesterday.
Nice.
Paul was like, awake till whatever time getting this ready. So we sent it off for mastering yesterday, so we'll get that back on Tuesday. And then I think it's being released in New Zealand and Poland and Germany, and then I think here as well, cool. In about July time.
Nice.
We haven't got a release date yet, but we're trying to tee up the release dates so we can just drop it all at once to all the countries. Otherwise, we'll end up doing what we did last time with the first album, and it kind of dropped in New Zealand, and then it dropped somewhere else, and then it was like a staggered kind of release. Ideally, we just want to go bang and just drop it everywhere.
Why do you think you're so big in New Zealand?
Because Paul and Shelton have had so much success in New Zealand before.
Shelton was in
a band called Blindspot.
Blindspot, who then turned into Blacklist.
They
were like new metal sort of thing, weren't they?
They were like New Zealand's very own Limp Bizkit.
Yeah.
That's the way I'd say it. He'd probably murder me for saying that. But they kind of were. They kind of blew up around. They were like the big new metal band in New Zealand kind of thing.
That's cool.
And a generation of kids grew up listening to them, you know? So they're massive. They're still big over there. Like Blacklist is still big over there and stuff. It's just... I don't know why we're obviously big over there because of Shelton and Paul's past history, because Paul produced the first Blindspot album.
Oh, okay.
So Paul's a well-known, Paul's like a really good producer of note over in New Zealand. Like he's like, it's a, bands like to talk about the fact that Paul's producing some of their stuff over in New Zealand, So he's a well-known producer over there. Shelton's a celebrity kind of thing over there, kind of thing with his drumming from Blacklist and stuff like that, or Blindspot. Basically, we were just able to get our feet off the ground, get airplay straight away over in New Zealand.
Yeah. Because his image has changed so much. Like
Shelton's.
Yeah.
Oh, he just loves his tattoos, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Just an awesome guy, loves his tattoos, loves his photography and stuff. So just going with that vibe at the moment.
Cool. So this won't be your last album, will it?
No, thank God. No, not at the moment, no. At the moment, we're so just focused on getting through the touring period and seeing the life cycle of the second album through and trying to line everything up, you know, with like how we're trying to line all the dots up with releasing the second album and stuff like that. And after that, who knows what we're going to do, you know, we just don't know at the moment. But at the moment, there is no plans to, we aren't going like, we're not going to go, oh, we're going to split up kind of thing. No way. We're going to carry on, man. Of course we do.
Whose decision was it to make the video in Germany?
All of our decisions, really, yeah. It was like, I can't remember how the guy came into the Soren and everybody came into touch with us. I think it was through our manager, Teresa. Yeah. Because one of the other bands that she manages puts in touch with the guy, Soren, because they're quite big in Germany, one of Teresa's other bands that she manages. They put us in touch with this guy.
Nice.
And we just loved his vibe. We just loved what he was doing with it. We just thought, wow, it's going to be an amazing experience for us to go and record the video with these really talented German directors, and so we were just like, fuck it, let's just spend the money and do it, you know. And it works so well because it's a wicked video, it is one of our better videos, you know.
It took ages to come out in the UK though.
Yeah, I know, sorry about that.
So guys posting it like, new video's out, click on it.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck off, I can't watch it.
It got leaked about a week after we released it in New Zealand. Some Russian website.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it got leaked on some Russian website. And it was only on there for about, I think it was on there for about 2 or 3 days. And then Sony New Zealand just were like, nah, you got to get that off.
Huh?
And just managed to get it off there. But it got leaked on some Russian website. It had about like 300 views or something. I was like, who the fuck in Russia is listening to our band? I was like, what the fuck?
It's amazing. Right, well, cheers, man.
Oh, man. Cheers, dude.
Thanks, pleasure.
No worries, dude.